In this video, I will show you how much a Range Rover loses per year and if this rate is indeed as high as everyone claims it is. What's up YouTube and welcome to a new video. So let's say that you decided that you need a big SUV in your life. And when you start to think about which one would fulfill your needs, you end up with a Range Rover. And why not? They look impressive and less vanilla than their German rivals. Moreover, it's one of the few SUVs which can actually go off-road. Now, confident as you are, you start to Google for some reviews and that's when the doubt kicks in. You will namely find that, besides that they are good off-road, the reliability is not as good as you hope and the depreciation is extremely high. Now, I'm not a car mechanic, so we're not going to talk about the reliability in this video. We will, however, dive very deep in the depreciation numbers. You see, many of these so-called high and low depreciation claims are based on anecdotal evidence only. But I like to check the data to find out what the actual rate is. In this video, we will then also investigate if Range Rovers indeed have such a high depreciation rate. And to do this, we are going to follow a few steps. First, I will introduce you to the Range Rover Sport market. I namely chose this type as an example for the video. In the second step, we will have a look at the depreciation numbers. And in the third step, we will compare these numbers to the one of a Porsche Cayenne. In the fourth step, we will compare them then to all of the other cars which I've analyzed on the channel. And all the way at the end of the video, we will conclude. So I suggest that you sit tight because we will go through quite some data. If you, by the way, like this data-driven approach, please have a look at my channel as you will find depreciation analysis for many cars over there. If you can't find the car you're looking for, you can also comment the name of that car down below in the comment section. Once there are enough requests for a certain car, I will make a video about it. Don't forget then to subscribe and smash that notification bell so you get actually notified when your requested analysis goes live. Let's start now with step number one, and that means that the Range Rover Sport market is appearing on your screen. Now before we start, let me say that I only included the V8 petrol models for this analysis. Also, you can see that I split the market by trim level. We have the Supercharge, Autobiography, SVR, HSE and HSE Dynamic. Let me run you through the numbers so you get a feeling for the market. In total, there are 750 cars included and you can see that the prices vary a lot. Also note that there are quite many cars included from model year 2021. The cars over here and the ones from model year 2020 are then also mainly new cars. Now, besides that, we can clearly see that the SVR is the most expensive, followed by the Autobiography and the Supercharged. We can also see that there's a break in the market over here. The cars from model year 2018 onwards are namely the facelifted version. And these got, among other things, an upgraded multimedia system. And as you can see from the prices, this was clearly appreciated. The cars from model year 2018 are namely $17,800 more expensive than the ones from 2017. And this is the second largest price change in the market. So, you now know how the market looks like, and that means that it's time to have a look at the depreciation and see how bad the situation is. Before we continue though, please remember to support the channel by smashing that like button. The depreciation curves are now appearing on your screen, and let's first cover the numbers. The SVR has the highest depreciation rate and loses on average $19,500 per year, or 14%. This is followed by the Autobiography at a rate of $12,300 per year, or 13%. The Supercharged trim depreciates the least with a rate of $10,500 per year, or 12%. Now we need to keep a few things in mind over here. All of these numbers are averages and mainly influenced by the drop in the first year. You can see, for example, that an SVR loses $27,000, or 20%, just in its first year. A second thing to take into account is the difference between the facelifted and the pre-facelifted cars. Like I mentioned earlier, this causes a break in the price pattern. So let's split the market one step further. You can see now that each trim level is broken down by a facelift version and a pre-facelift version. And this really emphasizes the price differences between them. Look, for example, at the SVR from model year 2017. They are just as expensive as the Supercharged cars from model year 2018. You can also see that for the older models, the drop between 2018 and 2017 is actually larger than the drop between 2019 and 2020. So if you are in the market for a Range Rover Sport, it is important to consider if you really want a facelifted version or that you perhaps value performance more and want an older SVR. Also, if you decide that the facelifted version is the one you want, you need to take into account that these cars are not going to drop this much in 1 year. They are namely better than the pre-facelifted cars, and therefore the depreciation curve will go above the one of the pre-facelifted versions. And these type of market breaks and patterns in the depreciation are very typical for car markets. I see it over and over again. Now, I also checked the depreciation per 1,000 miles graph, and the picture there is more or less the same. But we will come back to that at a later point. The big question is, of course, are the depreciation numbers which I just showed you indeed that high? But to answer that question, we need to have some reference points. How else are we going to assess what is high and what is low? Therefore, we will use two reference points. First, I will compare the curve of the Range Rover Sport to the one of the Cayenne Turbo. After that, I will also compare it to all of the other cars which I've analyzed on the channel. So let's have a look at the depreciation curve of the Cayenne, and that comparison should be appearing now on your screen. You can see that I inserted now the Cayenne Turbo in the graph, and this only includes the Turbo. The Turbo S and the Turbo E Hybrid are not included. Now we can see here, first of all, that the average new price is higher than for the SVR. The gap over here is $14,200. And to be honest, this surprised me. I thought that they would be way closer. So what about the depreciation? Let me first put the numbers for the Range Rover on the screen. Now then, the Cayenne. This car has a higher absolute depreciation rate at $19,000 per year. However, as you can see, it is also more expensive from new. Relatively, it depreciates at a rate of 12.5% per year. And this is a score which is very close to the Autobiography and slightly better than the SVR. Now, due to the higher absolute number, you can see that the curve of the Cayenne dives under the one of the SVR. Also here though, there are a few things to consider. The first drop what you see is natural. The Cayenne loses here $32,000 versus $27,000 for the SVR. And relatively, this equals to 21% versus 20%. So they lose more or less the same. However, in the second year, the depreciation curve for the Cayenne doesn't flatten and it loses again $32,000. And this is different for the SVR, as that car only loses $7,000 in its second year. Now, an important factor over here is the introduction of the new Cayenne. This causes a price break in the market and causes an exaggeration in the depreciation. And this is simply the same effect as what we saw in the Range Rover market between the facelift and the pre-facelifted cars. Now, I also compared the depreciation per 1,000 miles driven, so let's also have a quick look at that. You can see that we have the miles now on the horizontal axis and that the price is still displayed on the vertical axis. You can also see that we have the Turbo in red and the SVR in green. Now you can see that especially for the cars under 40,000 miles, the curves are very similar. For the higher mileage cars, there is some difference. However, you can see that for the Turbo, the shaded area is very large over there. And that means that there is a lot of uncertainty in the estimation. We simply have too few observations. All right, let's stop here for a moment and talk about what we've actually seen. So, based on the comparison to the Cayenne, I would say that there's nothing unique about the depreciation rate of the Range Rover. There are some differences, but in the grand scheme of things, the cars follow the same depreciation pattern. But this was, of course, only our first reference point. So how does it compare to all of the other cars which I've analyzed on the channel? Let's have a look. And we will investigate this with the depreciation leaderboard. This leaderboard compares all the cars based on the age of the car market and the relative average depreciation. Now, the SVR is 5 years old and the depreciation rate sits at 14% per year. If we find the right bubble on the chart, then we can see that it scores quite poor and far below the trend line. Only the V12 Vantage S depreciates with a higher rate of 15.4% per year. You can also see that the Macan Turbo, the Rolls-Royce Ghost, and the Lamborghini Huracan score slightly better. Let's have a look now at the Autobiography and the Supercharged trim. These are 1 year older and depreciate at rates of 11 and 13%. And with these scores, they also score below the trend line. Only last year's BMW i8 market scored worse. If you, by the way, want to know more about that i8 market, then I recommend that you check out my full depreciation analysis on that car. I namely updated it 2 weeks ago, and you can find it by clicking on the pop-up banner over here. So, back to the Range Rovers. Even though that the Autobiography and Supercharged trim level score below the trend line, they score a lot closer to the trend line and to the other cars than the SVR. In fact, the autobiography almost overlaps with the rate of a 911 Turbo S. And on that note, we're going to wrap up and conclude. We started the video with the question, do Range Rovers depreciate indeed so extreme as claimed by many? And the answer to this question depends on what you are used to. If you compare it to the rate of a Cayenne Turbo, then you see that the rates for the SVR are close to identical. So from that point of view, the depreciation rate for a Range Rover is not that strange for its class, luxury SUVs. However, when you compare it to cars outside of its class, so non-luxury SUVs, then you can see that the depreciation rate is higher, especially for the top-of-the-line SVR. For the autobiography and the supercharged trims, the rate is also higher, but the gap to the other cars is not that big. At least, in my opinion, not big enough to speak of an extremely high depreciation rate. And with that, we arrived at the end of the video. Now, if you enjoyed this video, please remember to support the channel by smashing that like button. Also, don't forget to comment down below with a car for which you would like to see an analysis. As always, a huge thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next week for a new video.